it fructifies to give the experience in this body. Therefore, that Karan Sharir is like a stock kept in Swiss bank. So you take little bit of that money and use it for your business and all. But the majority is kept there. Therefore, I had compared it. Account number and all I had not mentioned, so that we can avoid. Swamiji, is chitta shuddhi an effort towards it in prarabdha? I am unable to understand the meaning of self-effort when you talk about surrender. See, we have to keep putting forth effort without worrying about whether it is in our prarabdha or it is in self-will and all. You keep putting forth effort. Because when we are hungry, we put forth effort to eat. We don't wait there and say, prarabdha mein hoga, to aa jayega, laddu, muh mein. You will be sitting like that only. So you keep putting forth effort to do your sadhana. And effort we have to put forth till we hold on to that pure I am. Once we hold on to that pure I am, we have to surrender to it. Surrender to our own being. Thereafter, that supreme reality take over. Our effort is till we reach that door of I am. And before that we have to gain the vairagya, gain the proper understanding. For that we have to put forth effort. And after putting forth effort, once we reach that abode of meditation, in that high state of meditation, we have to let go of all our effort and just hold on to it. Just let go of all effort and the Supreme will take over. Again, like our sleep. We have to put forth effort in the beginning to go to sleep. But once we reach a particular stage of sleep, then we have to just let go and the sleep take over. So that is the meaning of effort, and then also about surrender. So surrender comes at the end, not in the beginning. Surrender comes final stage. Final stage is surrender. It's like a person pole vault. So with the help of the pole, one can jump to a high level. Then you drop the pole and just surrender to the gravity. And you just fall on the other side. Don't have to do anything. Even if you do something, it will be useless only. So just relax and let yourself fall on the other side. Does God really exist? If yes, then why we can't see Him? God really exists, and He exists as you. And also God exists as this world. So it is not true that we can't see God. Only we don't see God of our idea. That is the, we have idea God must be like Krishna with Murli and all, and I should be able to see. That God you might not be able to see. But the world, Bhagavan says, I am the world. So world, if you can see the world, you are seeing God. If you can see the other person, you are seeing God. If you are looking into the mirror, you can see your face, you are seeing God. If you are eating, drinking, sleeping, touching, walking, talking, then you are seeing God. Because that is what God is. God says, I am in the water. Rasoham apsu kaunteya, I am the rasa in water, the taste in water. If you can taste that taste, then you are tasting God. Bhagavan says, I am the fire, I am the heat in the fire. You just put your finger in fire and check it out. If you can feel something, then you are feeling God. Bhagavan says, I am the light in the sun. So if I can see that light, I am seeing God. So God is not our idea of God. Everyone has got their own idea of God. And that idea might be wrong. And those wrong ideas we don't see. So God is, He exists. He exists as the world and He exists as your own self, as your higher self. So to see Him, you have to be Him. As in his supreme form, if you want to see him, you just be him. If you want to see him as his expression, then look at the world and see him like that. A realized master is firmly established in Turiya, in Brahman. Does he experience dreams and deep sleep? See, for a realized master also, one who is established, firmly established in Turiya, then there is no dream, there is no sleep, there is no nothing. Then that a person is called, he has gone beyond that Turiya also. Turiyatita it is called. One who is firmly established in Turiya, his body also gets dropped off and he becomes one with Brahma. But one who is not firmly established in Turiya can come into waking state, dream state, deep sleep state also. But even when he comes into the three states, he recognizes, he knows that he is that Brahma. So he is a Jivan Mukta Purusha only, who has experienced that Turiya, is a Jivan Mukta, but still he also wakes up, he also dreams, he also goes into deep sleep state, but he is not ignorant, he knows his real self. Since all consciousness is the same, and we are all one, then why such differences in behavior, thought? How do these differences come about? And at what stage do they start to come about? Since we are all the amsha of the same one reality. Yes, all consciousness is same, but the prakriti has got 24 tattvas and it is not same. Prakriti is different. The gunas are different, rajogun, tamogun, sattvagun, and their permutation combinations are different. So all differences what you see is prakriti. All oneness you see, that is purusha. So it depends on where you are looking. If you are saying that all consciousness is same, then look at consciousness. You will see it same anyway. But if you see differences, then you will see prakriti. And prakriti is different. The colors are different, the temperatures are different, the different bodies are different, the minds are different, the intellect are different. So they can't be same. And the tamasic mind will behave differently, sattvic will behave differently. So they are not the same. So outwardly you will not find the world same, but the essence of everything is same. So these differences are always there in the world. And the oneness is also always there in the world. Depends on where you are looking. If you look at prakriti, you are bound. If you look at that purusha, you become free. Sukshma sharir, karan sharir ke bare mein vistrut jankari dene ki kripa kare. Maine abhi vistrut jankari di hai. Sukshma sharir jo hai wo पंचज्ञानेन्द्रिय पंचकर्मेंद्रिय पंच प्राण मन बुद्धि चित्त अहंकार से बना हुआ है, उसे सूक्ष्म शरीर कहते हैं. और इसका जो कारण है, स्थूल शरीर और सूक्ष्म शरीर का भी जो कारण है, उसे कारण शरीर कहते हैं. कारण शरीर हमारे संस्कार से बना हुआ होता है, उसमें संस्कार है, पूर्व जन्मों के, अनेक जन्मों के संस्कार उसमें है. तो उसे कारण शरीर. मोर डिटेल ऑफ दिस यू कैन स्टडी इन टेक्स्ट लाइक विवेक चूड़ामणि और आत्मबोध, तत्वबोध, वेदांत के ग्रंथ है, उसमें डिटेल यू कैन नो अबाउट इट. इफ वी आर ऑल वन कॉन्शियसनेस, व्हाई डोंट वी फील अदर पीपल्स इमोशंस? इंटरेस्टिंग क्वेश्चन. हाँ, it is good that we don't feel other people's emotion. Our own emotions are so difficult for us to control, and if you start feeling other people's emotion, it will be the total headache only. Ki mummy kya soch rahi hai, agar aapko pata chal gaya, so that will be very difficult for you. So one thing is, it is good that we can't feel other person's emotion. Otherwise you can't sit next to each other, I tell you. Really. अगर वो दूसरों का इमोशन पता चले, दैट इज द ग्रेट ब्लेसिंग गिवन अस बाय भगवान, कि हमारा मन छिपा के रखा. इफ यू, I will tell you, if suppose somebody tells you, or if you say that I can read your mind, oh, this one Swami is there, or some Mahatma is there who can read your mind, people will be afraid to go to him. Because they will say, mera man padega to kya kahega? So better not go there. So consciousness is one, but the minds are many. So consciousness, when I say I, it is that consciousness identified only with one body, mind, intellect. So the consciousness which is identified with other body, mind, intellect, if you identify with that supreme consciousness, you will be able to know what is happening in all the minds. But if you are identified only with that consciousness which is identified with only your body, mind, intellect, you will not be able to. It's like your computer. When you are not connected to the www, then whatever is in your computer itself, you know. But when you get connected to the internet, then you can know what is happening in the other computer also. You can chat with the other person also. भगवान ने कहीं परा अपरा, कहीं प्रकृति पुरुष, कहीं क्षेत्र क्षेत्रज्ञ, कहीं क्षर अक्षर जो कहा है वह क्या विशेष अर्थ के लिए कहा है, जबकि सबका अर्थ एक ही है. आई एम नॉट लिटिल क्लियर अबाउट द सेम विथ रिगार्ड्स. आई हैड मेंशन दैट सबका, ऑल दिस टर्म्स आर यूज फॉर द सेम थिंग, बट दे हैव स्लाइट डिफरेंट नुआंसेस which you must have noticed when we had studied those texts. First Bhagwan talked about para and apara prakriti. He only talked about prakriti, but he divided them into para and apara. Para he called it like jiva, and apara as the changing, the ashtadha prakriti. Bhumi rapo nalo vayu kham mano buddhi revacha अहंकारिति यम्मे भिन्ना प्रकृतिर अष्टधा. एंड देन ही यूज दिस वेरियस अदर टर्म्स इन द क्षेत्र क्षेत्रज्ञ ऑल्सो आई हैड एक्सप्लेन व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ क्षेत्र एंड व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ क्षेत्रज्ञ. सो द सेम दिस टू टर्म्स आर यूज विद डिफरेंस इन स्लाइट डिफरेंस इन देयर मीनिंग सो दैट यू विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड एंड अप्रिशिएट इट from a different standpoint. So now I may not be able to go into details about it, but like Purusha means that which is existing in the Pura. Prakriti means that which was first created, like Prathama Kriti. So all these terms have got their own significance, but if you understand the main meaning, that when we say Prakriti, it is the seen, and when we say Purusha, it is the seer. That much only, if you understand, that is enough. Swamiji, I am a 60-year-old woman with a fulfilling life, children, husband, family, material wealth. What should my spiritual path be for the next 20 years? Please explain in a few steps. First of all, you have a plan that 20 years you won't get realization, you have to do something for 20 years. See, just you have to, spirituality is, you should be able to do your sadhana for 1 minute, for one moment, and you have to just extend that moment. And that 1 moment sadhana is to simple sadhana is to remember your own self, remember your own higher self while doing whatever you are doing. Like in the 8th chapter, Bhagavan has said, Mam anusmara yudhya cha. So remember your own higher self and do whatever. And for that simple thing, also our Mahatmas have said, Namasmaran. So you give a name to that higher self, Ram or Krishna, whatever name. and just remember that name and just continue doing your daily duties or whatever you are doing. But other path of spirituality, seriously, if you want to attain that state of enlightenment within before 20 years and all, then you have to follow it seriously, gain vairagya, and then follow the path of self-inquiry and surrender. I know that fear, worry, anxiety are in the mind and not in the I. Yet in some situation I am affected by this. How to get out of this situation? If you are affected, then you are identified with it. So for that you have to deal with it by cultivating positive values. Like fear can be overcome by gaining proper understanding. Even worries can be overcome by proper understanding. With faith in the higher power. So by developing values like ahimsa, satyam, asteya, brahmacharya, aparigraha, and for fear and all, deep faith in yourself and in that your own supreme self, when we have that deep faith, then we will not have this fear and anxiety and all. And again, continue doing your duties with that faith in that supreme, and you will be able to overcome these anxieties. Though all these anxieties and all are not in the I, but when that I identifies with the mind, then it seems to be there in the I. So if you want to get rid of it completely, then just sit in that I consciousness alone. Let the anxieties and all be in the mind and be the witness of these anxieties. Briefly main bol raha hu, you might not be satisfied with, you might get more anxiety. Swamiji ne thoda bol ke ab rakh diya kagaj. So you have faith in God. Earlier three words constituting Om were enunciated by Swamiji in a sublime and simple manner. With folded hands, I request to once again do the same, time permitting. If you remember when earlier, you can buy my this CD. All the CDs and DVDs and all are available, and they are there. I don't remember exactly what you mean earlier, because every time that Om comes and I talk about it in different ways. So Om is the supreme, that reality alone is indicated by the term Om. As yesterday also I was saying that Om and Aham is same. Different way of expressing that Aham is Om. So Om when we is also indicator of that supreme. So in that Om there are these three letters are there, A, U, Ma, and then the silence is there. So A indicate the Jagrat Avastha, U indicate the Swapna Avastha, Ma indicate the Sushupti Avastha, and the silence indicate the Turiya Avastha. So with the help of Om and understanding the meaning of these three avasthas and the connection with these three letters, we have to meditate and try to reach that state of Turiya. So Om also becomes like a help, like a support to reach the state of Turiya. So it is called Etad Alambanam Shrestham, Etad Alambanam Param. In Kathopanishad, the Om is called as Alambanam. Alamban means support to recognize the Supreme. So that also you can see.